Can we get started? Sure. So my voice is loud and clear, right? You guys able to listen to me? I mean, hear me?
Yes, Santosh, we can hear you.
Okay. So I see a few people are just pinging or texting, but okay. So let's get started. A warm welcome to you all guys for the Selenium training. Let me introduce about myself first. I'm Santosh. I have overall 10 years of experience in IT, out of which 7 years into automation testing using Selenium. Apart from Selenium, I do have an experience working with performance testing and security testing as well. I'm based out of India and I'm currently working for MNC company called Capgemini as a QA offshore lead. So this is a quick introduction about myself. And so we have around 8 people in this meeting. So just for my understanding, you guys have a prior knowledge to Selenium, or like this is your first time, or like how it is. Can we have a quick round of introduction? Just about yourself and your interest. That's all. So let's go one by one.
Yeah, hi Santosh. Can you hear me?
Yep, I'm able to listen to you.
Okay, hi Santosh. My name is Abha. And I'm a commerce background student, so I have no idea about Selenium and all. But I want to get into this industry, so that's why I'm taking this manual and Selenium. I've completed my manual testing training, and now I'm looking forward for the Selenium training.
Okay, that's great. Abha, right?
Yeah, Abha.
Okay. So welcome to the world of Selenium now. So you're ready to learn some coding stuff.
Yeah, so that's why I'm a little hesitant that whether, I have no background of any language or something. So how comfortable will I be? I'm a little hesitant, but I still want to start.
Yes, so it's not that a rocket science that you cannot learn it. I'll make this coding as simple as possible for you to have a grasp, so absolutely no worries, and you don't have to even worry a bit about it. I'll ensure that you will... I'll ensure my teaching will be as simple as possible so that you will love coding.
Oh, thank you so much. I'm looking forward to learn then.
Okay. What about the core? Java or Java you have?
I'm sorry, I cannot hear you.
Abha, you... do you have a fair idea about the language what we will be using here? It is Selenium, but Java.
Java, yes. Yes, I was told about that. Yes.
Okay, so are you aware about the Java?
No, I'm not, to be honest.
Okay, Abha, no problem. We'll take it ahead.
You can let me know if I can start up with something on my own. If you want me to look ahead and, explore, go on YouTube or something. If you can guide me.
Not required for now. Let me I'll try to cover best possible. If the assessment or the assignments what I'll be giving, if you do it as a homework, that will be really helpful for you.
All right. So you're telling me that even if I don't have the background, I can still learn it and I can still do it. I understand it's not a rocket science, but even people with no background can do it.
Yes, even with people with no background of coding can start learning Selenium with Java, and the main area that you have to focus now more than Selenium is core Java.
Yeah.
So I recommend you going to some websites or mainly like that, because if you understand the Java concepts very well, then Selenium is very easy.
Gotcha.
You need to focus more on Java, but Absolutely nothing to worry, because Java is very simple. I'll make it very simple for you.
All right. Thank you so much. Thank you.
So shall we move on to the next person?
Hi Santosh, this is Falguni.
Hi Falguni.
Actually, I am not in a like IT background, but I had a knowledge in manual testing, and I completed with the H2K Infosys, and now I move forward to the one language. I am very interested in learning about the Java, because I heard lots of about it, and from the Google and everything basic I know about that, but I want to know more about deeply, like a core Java and everything, how to do that practically.
Okay. That's great for the needle. We'll cover the Java context first. Yeah, thank you. So thank you. Shall we move on to the next person? Yeah.
Hi Sandhya, this is Swati. Actually, I'm doing testing from past 15 years, so I do have experience in manual and some automated, but don't have experience in Selenium. I've did web service testing and all those API testing, but want to learn.
So you have over 15 years of experience in IT swapping?
Yeah, IT, more of manual side. Yeah.
And so since you know the web services and other thing, and I really appreciate your interest in learning Selenium now, can you tell me more what fascinated you to learn Selenium?
Yeah, because nowadays, actually, recent project I worked for 8 years, which was manual testing. So when I came out, lot of new technologies came up. They are using Selenium. So thought of learning Selenium to get into new projects. Because nowadays everybody is using Selenium for regression and everything, so thought it would be helpful for me.
Okay, so you did mention that you have worked on little automation as well. So which tool were you using mainly?
The recent ones or the automation you're talking about?
The automation ones. Have you used any tool?
Yeah, I used QTP and WinRunner long back.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
okay, that's good. Okay. So I really appreciate your interest in learning Selenium, and we'll work together. So yes, can we move on to the next person?
Hey Santosh, my name is Shanti.
Hi Shanti.
Hey, I have IT background. I have 8 years of experience in manual testing. I would like to learn Selenium and JavaScript. That's why I'm attending today. I wanted to know how it's going to be. That's why today, once I will listen today's class, then I want to enroll.
Yeah, sure, Shanti. Okay, that's good, and thank you for your interest.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hello, this is Shobham, and I've done my this one manual testing from H2K. Now that Selenium is the hottest tool, so I would like to learn about it. That's why I'm taking the demo class.
So okay, Shobham.
Hey Santosh. So my name is Shanti. I have a question.
Yeah,
I learned automation before, but I never used in my 7 years, 8 years of experience in my career. All 8 years I'm doing manual testing. If I learn Selenium, it will be helpful for me, or I need to know about the automation also. I have to learn this also. I already learned, but I never used.
Thing is that, as Shobha told, okay, there's automation. This whole IT industries are moving on a trend called automation. So everything is getting automated. And with automation, when it comes to automation, yes, there was a time where a typical manual testing was required for everything, but I'm not telling that manual testing life is in threat. But yes, the automation is taking the upper hand. And Selenium, why it is becoming so famous, we'll get to know in a very short moment.
And with the Selenium, I can do automation also, right?
Yeah, Selenium is an automation. It's Selenium is an automation tool.
Once I learn the Selenium, I can do more on automation, right?
You can work on more on automation. You can practice daily on the demo sites. I will give you a few demo sites. Whatever I will be covering in the class, you can just automate. That is just take that and shift it to your real world application. For example, if you're working on some manual testing and if you've been given test case to automate, okay, let me give you a simple example. A test case tells verify the error message when a user enters a wrong password. So according to the manual test case, what you will do, you will just launch the browser, enter the URL, enter the username, enter the wrong password, and click on the sign in button. The moment you click on the sign in button, there should be some message which should be displayed either in red or some color stating that please input the correct username and password. So you have to verify that. And this is called a negative testing from manual perspective, right?
Mm-hmm.
So instead of you manually doing it, you'll be coding it. You'll be writing a code using Eclipse IDE, and with the help of Java, you'll be writing a code. So instead of manually doing it again and again and again, you'll just write a code once and run the script.
Okay.
So absolutely, if you learn Selenium, yes, you can automate any application, web application end to end. Is that answers your question, Shanti?
Yes, thank you. Yep.
Yes. So we have two more persons, Meena and Veena. Meenu and Veena, sorry.
Yeah, hi, this is Meenu here. Meenu Gupta.
Hi,
can you
Meena.
Hear me?
Yeah.
Hi. Hey. I've been doing manual testing for last 5 years, and at my workplace, I've started Selenium by myself, and I'm using the IDE IntelliJ Gradle. So I'm trying to teach myself, but I'm stuck. So that's the reason I want to join a class and get more clarity on that. So that's my purpose to be in this class. Okay. So I want to see the demo and
no problem, I will teach you how to use the Selenium IDE and make you familiarize with the concepts of automation. A warm welcome to you.
Okay, thank you so much. Yeah, I want to see the demo, how it goes, and then I can decide. Okay, thank you.
And we have one more person left, Veena.
Yeah, hi Santosh, this is Veena. So I'm also having 8 years experience in manual testing. So the start thinking of moving to automation now, as it's hot everywhere. So that's why I just listened to this demo class.
Okay, that's good. So everyone here out in this meeting, so they want to learn automation, and people are there, some are experienced or some are just wanted to showing the interest to learn automation. But manual testing, in the first place, you people can able to see my screen, right?
Yes.
All right, so how this automation came into an existence and how this automation came into a picture, why are we going into an automation? We have a manual testing team everywhere, and we manual testers are there to test the application, and that is what our job is. The big question is how this automation came into an existence. Let me give you a simple example. You wanted to let's take a developer is building an application, and there were five or six builds over. So being a manual tester, I've been testing the build 1, build 2, build 3, build 4, build 5. During the build 6, once again, the manual tester has to test all the functionalities from build 1 to build file, correct?
Yes.
So friends, like if you feel or finding it difficult to follow or like, you know, to like, you know, understand, interrupt and ask me questions. I know Abba and Paguni, they both, they don't have even manual testing experience, right?
Yes, Santosh, we don't have. I don't have.
Okay.
I did a healthcare applications. I did a manual testing, so I had an experience on that one. My background is healthcare, and okay. I did that application, the insurance applications. I manually tested them. So. But 6 months, okay. Not more than that. Yeah.
Okay. No worries. Let's take a developer wants to build a product. The product is this one, and let's name this product as ABC. So any developer means a person who is developing a software. Any developer, he cannot build the complete product at one go. It will be in stages. We also call it as builds in software. Abba, this is for you.
Okay, thank you.
Because like others know what is built and how it has been tested and what is manual testing. Since you don't have this this knowledge, so let me explain it to you so that like, you know, everybody will be on the same page. So all the small components together will form a big software. Software is nothing but any web-based application. For example, Yahoo mail.com. As you see, it's just a mail, but it's a software. So to build a Yahoo mail, so he has to build component by component. First he has to build credential homepage. Next, login page. Next, compose mail. So he has to build a complete software. He has to build 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 like the stages, and these all combinedly known as a software. Mm-hmm. Abhay, you're getting it?
Yes. I learned this in manual testing.
So if we wanted to test, let's take this build. You're testing it now.
Mm-hmm.
So this is the current build. But you have already tested this 4 builds earlier. Now you wanted to test the build 4. Will you be testing only the build 4 or even the previous builds?
I don't have idea.
Okay, so whenever you get a current build, if you wanted to test the build 4, you're not going to test only the build 4. You have to test even all the previous builds to ensure that whatever they've deployed in build 4 or the functionality of build 4 doesn't break the other functionalities. So we are doing the repeat
regression testing.
So we are doing the repetitive work again and again and again.
Priya told me about the regression testing. Whenever new thing is added in the software, we have to go ahead and test it together to make sure that nothing is broken by adding this none of the feature.
So exactly. So adding this feature, nothing is broken. Mean to tell that adding the feature 4, the previous features is not getting broken. But so we are in build 4. What about build 5, build 6, build 6, build 7, build 8, build 9? So it keeps going. So will you be testing each and every time from build 1 to build N? It's a kind of a donkey work, right?
Mm-hmm.
So to overcome this, okay, there was a tool called, to overcome all this repetitive tasks, we go for automation. In automation, we are focusing on Selenium.
Alright.
So you guys able to see my screen?
Yes.
So there are many tools available in market to do the automation. Why we are using Selenium? In the first place, let's start with what is Selenium. Selenium is a free open source web application automation tool. It is free because user don't need to buy any commercial license to use the software. And open source, the complete code of the Selenium automation tool can be downloaded from their official website. Any doubt here? And any question?
I'm good.
No questions.
This Selenium enables user to automate browsers. Okay. We are not using Selenium, we cannot automate any standalone application. What I meant by standalone application is that any software that is being installed on your machine, for example, any application like, you know, Winamp and other stuff, or VLC player, these are all called standalone application and that cannot be automated. Selenium can automate only web application. And Selenium supports only web automation, not desktop or standalone application. And you people got to know what do you mean by standalone application, right?
Standalone means the calculator is a standalone or?
Yes. Calculator is a standalone. And any, so you'll be down, antivirus is a standalone. And the softwares, or the simple media players, what you install on your desktop, that is standalone. These are standalone applications. And any application which is being accessed through the browser, any browser is called web application. So you got the difference between both? Any doubt? So moving on to a little history of Selenium, few years ago, there was only one automation tool and were available in market to do our regression testing. And that was owned by a company called Mercury. Now they named QTP, which was later took over by HP and currently known as UFT. Many people would be knowing what is UFT. And like for those who doesn't know what is UFT, UFT is a tool from HP to do our automation. And it's a competitor for Selenium as well. To use this tool, to use a QTP software, you require or your end user required to buy a license, and that license is too costly. These guys from ThoughtWorks have researched after many years. They found out a software, a person called Jason Huggins, a programmer at ThoughtWorks, developed an automation tool, and that tool is called Selenium. You know why he has named it as Selenium? Selenium is just a chemical name that is used to cure the wound caused by mercury. So funny, right?
So,
So this is very interesting. Why they named it as Selenium is that this guy have to find a medicine which was caused by mercury. And Mercury was a company which owned other automation tool called QTP.
QTP. Mm-hmm.
So it's very interesting. Selenium is nothing but a chemical name. So what are the programming languages supported by Selenium? Selenium supports Java. Selenium supports C Sharp, Ruby, Python, JavaScript, Perl, PHP, R, and Dart, etc. In our tutorial, we are going to focus on Java. And initial few classes, it will be only on Java. So how I have planned to take is that since people have enrolled for Selenium and Java is very much required, it will be 5 days of first initial few days of only Java class, because you have to be familiar with Java even to understand what is Selenium. And it will be like, you know, yeah.
Hey, Santosh, sorry to interrupt you. If I want to learn Selenium with C sharp, there is another class is there.
If you learn Selenium with Java, and if you get familiarized with what Selenium is, one API. These are the programming languages: Java, C sharp, Ruby. Okay. Okay, so once you get familiar with Java, and if you know the concepts of Java very well, and Selenium, I mean, like Selenium remains the common for everything. You have to be familiar with one of these languages. Yes, there is a like, you know, separate class for C sharp as well, Ruby as well, Python as well, but we are going with Java.
Okay, you don't have any classes like Selenium with C sharp?
Are you looking for any particular classes with Selenium with C sharp? I'll tell you, C sharp is a language, okay?
Yes,
so mainly they have, I mean, like using Selenium with C sharp, okay? So nowadays the industry uses Selenium with C sharp and also called as a framework called Spec Flow, and that, I mean, like, you know, that uses DDD. Anyways, like I'll give, while in our current class, I'll give a little idea about how Selenium with C sharp work also. Will that be fine?
Do you have any classes for the Selenium with C sharp?
I'm not sure. You have to check with the faculty over there.
Okay, yeah, thank you.
Okay. So what are the browsers that Selenium supports? As I've told earlier, Selenium, I mean, using Selenium, we can automate browsers. We can automate the web applications. To, like, you know, automate web application, we take the supports of browsers. So Selenium supports, initially, Mozilla Firefox was a browser which was, like, you know, closely attached to Selenium, guys. Selenium supports Chrome, IE, Safari, Opera, Microsoft Edge. What are the components or flavors of Selenium? So initially, when a person, Jason, developed a Selenium like IDE, it was the first component or let's take an automation tool of Selenium which came. So what is Selenium IDE? It is nothing but like a add-on in Mozilla Firefox. It was just an add-on and used to record and playback the scripts, and that is deprecated now, and no longer we will be using this. The next comes Selenium RC. This is the second component from, I mean, like, you know, this is a second component of Selenium. Again, this we will not be using it. Selenium RC as well, as it even got deprecated. And Selenium WebDriver and the latest version is 3.10. We will be focusing main only on Selenium WebDriver. Any questions? So, so someone asked earlier, are we gonna use Selenium C sharp? Right?
Yes.
Okay. From this picture, if you clearly observe, on top layer, it is binding. Binding meaning, like, you know, the program what we will be writing, C sharp, Java, Python, and so on. And the middle layer is the Selenium WebDriver API. And the final, on the last layer is the browsers. No matter, like, you know, do you, if you write the code on C sharp or even in Java or Python, this will interact with the WebDriver API, and that will the whatever the code what you have written in any of these languages will like make a connection to the browsers and make it execute. So that is the only difference. So WebDriver, Selenium WebDriver remains the same. The difference will come either the user wants to go with C sharp, Java, Perl, Python, etc. So they will be writing the code using this any one of these different languages. Okay, those languages will be like, if you write, let's take in an example, if you write in Java, system.out.println. So that will communicate to this web driver, and that web driver will work on this any of this browser, either Firefox, IE, Chrome. In C Sharp, open the browser. What I'm telling is, whatever the it irrespective of languages, any language, languages, what I meant is C Sharp, Java, Python, irrespective of languages, it is like you will be writing the code to their native according to the language specific. For example, in Java, if you wanted to open a browser, there is one command. And that command will be if you write the code, this web driver API will call that command and execute it according to the browser. Same thing in C Sharp, if you wanted to open a browser, there is one command, you have to just write it. And the Selenium web driver, the middle part remains the same. So if you learn the Selenium web driver, the language part, you can opt or learn by yourself. But in this course, we will be learning Java. Any doubts, questions? Friends, any doubt? Can we move ahead?
No.
Oh, I'm good.
Yeah, I'm good too.
Okay. For now, I'll explain the slide, but we will come back to this slide later because this involves a certain Java, Java words like interface and all. If I tell you what is interface now, you people will be having a little difficult to understand what is interface. I don't want to complicate it, but yes, this is the web driver architecture and previous architecture. This is the Selenium architecture and this is web driver architecture. I don't want to confuse you guys with this web driver architecture as it involves some programming specific words like interface, topmost interface, abstract method. I don't want you guys to get confused with this. So we will come back to the slide and I'll explain about this web driver architecture in future. Is this okay?
Yes.
Because the more I use a technical, difficult words, interface, abstract methods, people are tend to get scared. To make it very simple, we'll come back to the slide. Yes, people are running behind Selenium, and it too has a certain disadvantage. Since it's an open source tool and no reliable technical support will be available for Selenium. What I meant reliable technical support is that in QTP, if you find or if you want any option, it's not working or you don't know what to do, you can directly call the HP support center. They will open the ticket for you and they will fix it or be able to be help with the problem. But Selenium is an open source. There is no any support available. All you have to do is Google. Search in Google, find. One or the other person might have faced the same challenge. So you have to research for yourself. It does not support desktop application on Windows-based application, but QTP does support desktop and Windows-based application. Desktop and desktop application, what I meant is calculator. No other tool integration for test management. Again, this sentences complicated test man and what is test management and all, we'll come back to it. And for the person or for the people who's working in manual testing, they will be knowing this for what test management tool is. So test management tool.
Santosh, even I also know these test management tools, quality center, ALM.
Yes. So Selenium does not have direct integration with any of the tool, wherein QTP does have an integration with their own test management tool. For example, QTP and HP ALM plus HP UFT, they both are from the same vendors, HP. So they will be having that integration between those two tools, but Selenium doesn't have that.
Okay.
100% automation is not possible, and we cannot automate certain things in Selenium. CAPTCHA. You guys heard what is CAPTCHA, right? You know what is CAPTCHA?
Yes, yes.
CAPTCHA cannot be automated in Selenium.
I don't know about it.
Okay. Okay. For the person who doesn't know what is CAPTCHA, if you're entering into any secure website, let's take the bank website, there will be some image, or there will be some word, or there even audio file. You have to see that image and enter that into a below text box.
Got it.
That is CAPTCHA. Okay. That is like why they have most of the secure or banking or financial application, why they have CAPTCHA is that, okay, to prevent the robots access the application.
Yes. More hacking. Hacking should not be there.
Yes. So since we are you're automating using Selenium, okay, even this is kind of a robot. We are not doing anything. It will open the application, launch the browser, enter the URL, enter the username and password, it get into the application, test some functionalities. It will be doing everything by its own. But there are certain areas. For example, in an e-commerce, we are working on an application of our e-commerce application. You can automate from A to Z, from last on a payment page, that will be that CAPTCHA, one-time password and all will be there, right? That you cannot automate with Selenium. And that is what I meant, 100% automation is not possible. Online payment and verification through one-time password, again, this is this something which cannot be automated. Verification of audio and video clips, we cannot automate. We cannot automate audio and video clips. So these are certain advantage of Selenium and advantages. Yes, you people well aware, it is a hot cupcake, and also I've already told you it's a free open source, and it's just becoming very popular nowadays. And yes, the future is going to be for Selenium for next 5 to 10 years, 10 to 15 years. So the next topic on our session would be, what are the softwares required to get started with Selenium? Let me change this slide. So the next topic would be, what are the softwares to get started with Selenium? As well as we will be getting started with core Java first, the installation part and the basic program of core Java. Because to know or to get started with Selenium, people should be at least a little familiar with core Java, and that is very important.
And Santosh, can you please show us how much core Java are you gonna cover in this course, so at least we can get
You guys will be having visit their website. So presently I don't have a course outline for core Java. What I'll be doing is the next session, I will be giving all, I'll handpick of easy topics in core Java, which is very much required. Because I keep telling that core Java is important, I can just start up with the Selenium. But if I start up with the Selenium, will be not be able to follow up or understand. Then you will find it really difficult, I'm telling you. But once you know the required topic in core Java, this Selenium is just a piece of cake.
Hi, Santosh. One more question. In terms of this, over the course of this class, how would you break it down? Is it like an hour of class or 2 hours, or how many days and all those
things? That I will discuss with the faculty, and I will let you know how the class would be, or what will be the duration of the class. What we will do is check with those guys. The duration would be around 1.5 hours in that, for first initial few days, let's focus more on the core Java, and also we'll cover few topics in Selenium. I'll make it more interesting, not to worry. And a person with no coding knowledge, don't get feared. All right, don't get panicked. I'll make it as simple as possible for you guys.
And in terms of the assignment, is it based on the class what it covers?
Assignments is purely based on the class what I'm gonna cover on a daily basis, and the duration and other stuff you have to contact with the faculty. But generally speaking, only with Selenium, it will take about if it is 1.5 hours a day, it will take a month, considering 5 days in a week, only Selenium. And if it is Java, Java will take another 15 to 20 days. And that is what my rough calculation is, that to have a better clarity, like contact on the training support center, they will tell you what is the duration and other stuff.
So is there any kind of frameworks which you will cover as part of Selenium?
Yes, it will be complete end to end, from basic to building a framework. Framework is an advanced topic, and that if you could just go for any interview, they will not be asking what is this. They will be questioning you only the framework, what kind of framework have you worked, and etc. And don't worry, even the interview question I will be covering. Thing is that all I want from you guys is that you should be having a book or paper or whichever convenient way, and you have to keep or make, I mean, please make notes of it, because whatever, since we are not face to face, there are chances that whatever I'll tell and you people will be busy with some other things and you will miss the concepts or things, and later you'll find it difficult. So 1 hour or 1.5 hours or 2 hours, like dedicate yourself for you to get benefit out of this course. From my end, I can promise you that I will make this as simple as possible. From all I request from you guys is that you have to spend the complete 2 hours focused, make a note, and I will share the PPTs as well, whatever I'm preparing. And end of the day, whatever the source code which I'll be developing, what we will be doing or covering as in the part of class, I will be sending across that. Any questions from anyone?
Yeah, Santosh, I have a question.
Shanti, right? Yeah, Shanti.
Abha, I'm sorry.
Abha, yeah. Abha.
Yeah. Santosh, if you can give me any website or any trusted link where I can start learning about Java, so that at least I'm heads up, I have some knowledge. Simultaneously, I can start practicing.
Yeah. There are many websites, but what I prefer is you have to Google it, but there is one website called Tutorials.
Yeah, Tutorial Point. That's where I learned SQL language also.
Yes, yeah. And one more website is W3
Scroll. Okay, I know what you're talking. Okay, that's fine.
This is one, and don't worry, I'll get you. So this is my email. I'll share my email ID, and you can text me over there. I'll give you a few more websites, which is very easy.
All right.
So for now, you just go through this website.
Sure. Thank you.
Yes, apart from then, anyone has any questions?
Hey, Santosh. I'm Shanti. I have a question. Selenium, Selenium content and links and everything you will provide?
Yes.
Okay. Once we start the class, then end the class, then you'll provide all the.
Yes. Yes, Shanti. So what I'll be doing is I'll prepare a detailed course content and in an Excel, and we'll have three columns: the topics covered for the day, and as we cover each topic, we'll mark that topic as closure upon approval from all you guys. Like once you everybody is comfortable with the topic, we'll just mark that as complete and go, so that everybody will be on the same page and we will cover everything. So don't worry about it. And for the course content, you can visit their website. Visit H2K Infosys website, or you can talk to their faculty about like the course content. But yes, I will be like, you know, sharing the course content like along with them.
Okay. And you have only like classes Monday to Friday, weekend. Do you have any weekend classes?
Monday to Friday we will have, and if required, and if we miss any class, or if we require, I am okay even for a Saturday. Upon you guys, I mean, like, I'm okay, I'm flexible with the timings. It's upon you guys. If you guys wanted a class even on Saturday, yes, we can have a class, or we can have a class only for the discussion, doubts, clarification. Does that answer, Shanti?
Yes, yes.
Any more questions? Or we shall wind up for today.
Hello, Santosh. So the class is starting from tomorrow, right? Like, or it's going to be next week, or when it will be start?
I'm not sure about that, when it's gonna be. I will check with the faculty members on when the class is gonna be. But if the class is gonna be on the same timing, 6:30 a.m. IST and your timing 9 p.m. EST. So the very first topic what we will be covering is that installation part. A little brief about Java. I'm not gonna bore with the history and all. A little brief about the Java, and we will directly jump into a coding part. Wherever a theory is required, I'll cover the theory as well, but more than theory, it will be practical.
Okay, thank you.
So friends, any once again a warm welcome all of you guys, and thanks for showing interest and take the session on the Selenium. We'll meet up in our next actual classes.
Okay, thank you, Santosh.
Thank you so much. It was a lot of information. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Santosh.
Yes. Thank you, Santosh.
Yes. Welcome all, and have a nice day or good evening.
Yeah, thank you, Santosh.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.